Fellas, you're jumping off 1 minute 44 seconds of the second round. Your referee was forced to step in and stop the contest. Your winner, by way of TKO. Please, give it up.
Stopped in such a way, but you know what it is, that's boxing. Somebody wins, somebody loses. You seem to be doing quite well early doors and that. You tell me how you saw the fight going. Talking to the mic.
I can't remember
anything. I'll tell you what I'll do then. If you can't remember any of the fight, what I suggest you do, go backstage, go get a drink of water, go get it sorted out, see the doctor. All right? Seriously. Where's your coach? Because if he can't remember a thing, he needs to. Where's your trainer?
You alright?
Stay with him. He can't remember the fight.
Huh?
He can't even remember the fight.
Well, so he needs to be with his trainer.
Okay. Listen, that was a devastating knockout that you scored there. I'll tell you what, it seemed like a 50-50 fight going into it. You tell me, in your words, how you felt the fight went.
To be honest, the first half, I thought the first round was pretty much him, caught me some very good kicks, and then when I went back to the corner, give me some advice, great advice, and I just followed up, and that's what the outcome was.
To be fair, I heard your corner actually turn around and say that he was screaming, he was begging for a right hand,
yeah.
And you seemed to deliver it. So you're a strong kid, how many fights have you had?
It's my third one.
Your third?
Third, yeah.
Any KOs in that equation?
It's my second one.
Do you feel you're a bit of a banger?
Yes.
Well, I like that modestness, but do you feel that within yourself, if you connect properly with anybody, they're going to go?
Yes.
I like your humility, but you know what you need to do sometimes? You need to look in the mirror in the dead of the night and just say, I can and I will and I'm allowed to. Listen, all the best with you, I thought it was fantastic.